BBSRC-funded researcher Professor Alan Wilson studies movement in animals. His team are working towards an understanding of how very fast animals move in order to achieve remarkably high speeds. Having worked on racehorses and greyhounds, they have now moved on to study cheetahs. BBSRC went along to Whipsnade Zoo to see how Professor Wilson and his team are discovering information that can be used to understand limb injuries that affect motion in many animals, including humans.
So we're interested in animal locomotion in the broadest sense, where that's all the way from looking at dinosaurs, trying to understand the limits of them, for example, could Tyrannosaurus Rex run, to looking at the limits to performance, where performance is acceleration or turning or maximum speed running, in a range of animals, some of them racing animals like human sprinters, racing greyhounds, racehorses, through to understanding why they get injured, what the mechanisms of that injury are. So that's the sort of basic science of how animals work. The project we're doing here, we're looking at cheetahs. Cheetahs are fascinating because they are 50% faster than a racing greyhound or a racehorse, which has been bred for high-speed locomotion. We know that different limits exist for racing greyhounds and for humans. We don't know why the cheetah is so much faster. Is it just a little bit better in every way, or does it have fundamental differences in the way it runs that means it is so much quicker?
We want to find out what it is about cheetahs that make them able to run so fast. So to do that, we've got these cameras that are able to record at really high speeds. So your normal cameras will record at 25 frames per second. These ones will do up to 1,000. So we need that to be able to see every single little movement of their legs as they're running so fast. We have two on each side because when a cheetah gallops, it does different things with each side of its body. So it uses what we call an asymmetrical gait. We've got these plates in the ground here which are able to measure the forces that go through the legs. So they're basically like sophisticated Wii Fit boards that will measure all the forces that they're applying to the ground.
And we can start to determine the loads on the muscles and the skeleton and how much mechanical work they're having to do to actually gallop.
So this is our lure, and here you can see it's a big loop that goes all the way round, and with this piece we just attach a piece of chicken, which is just part of their ordinary diet, and she'll chase that quite happily. This is Arabia, so she's about 2 years old, and she's from Dubai, so she's actually a North African cheetah. This is her reward at the end, and she sits and happily munches after her little run. It's quite a nice way of just giving her a bit of enrichment as well. It's basically a big game to her. She loves it, and it kind of mimics what they would do in the wild for their food. We're just going to go and try and call her over, so I will probably take a piece of chicken with me. Now she's licking a bit, we can start the lure, and she knows the noise, so she'll come over hopefully. So here she goes.
She's incredibly quick.
So this is not just blue skies research to understand how animals work. It has more practical applications. We're using it to look at dairy cattle, where we want to detect which ones are lame, because lameness is a major welfare problem with dairy cattle. We're looking at people who've lost limbs and understanding the problems they have and how perhaps prosthetic limbs can be used to help them. We use it, similar work with cerebral palsy and looking at gait analysis, where you're trying to help the approach to managing people with these conditions. So it really has a practical application as well. Well, this is the first stage in what I hope is a program of work. So these cheetahs here are only running as fast as a racing greyhound. We hope to get cheetahs running in a larger area where they'll go faster, and perhaps also in the future go to Africa, where we can look at cheetahs when they're actually hunting and doing their maximum effort.